In the most shocking, perhaps, news of at least the past few months, the former leader of Japan, Shinzo Abe, was successfully assassinated. Devastating that late last night, the news came out that he had been shot, which is shocking not only because he's a former world leader, that he is in Japan, a country that has a very significant gun control laws, but that eventually the news broke hours later that he had passed as a result of it. He was most recently in office from December 2012 to September of 2020, was Japan's longest serving prime minister and resigned in 2020 for health reasons, but remained influential in politics. And in fact, he was shot at a sort of campaign speech. He had been appearing in public and giving a speech when he was attacked outside of a train station. Security officials were seen tackling a man in a gray t-shirt and beige trousers. He has since been identified as an unemployed 41-year-old. He admitted to doing it, and we are still trying to figure out what the motivation was. They say at this point that he believed Abe was part of a specific organization, which the individual had a grudge against, but we don't know what organization that's supposed to be a part of. The other, of course, important question is how exactly he managed to do this when, as we said, Japan has very severe gun control laws. Well, apparently police have confiscated several homemade weapons from a search of his house. They described the weapon that he used as being 40 centimeters long, 20 centimeters high, but also implied that they were treating it with caution due to the possibility of a detonation. And in fact, when we go to this picture, you'll see that it is in fact apparently something that was cobbled together, a homemade weapon. You can see in this shot. And we have a few actually of the weapon, I believe. We have that. Okay, well, we'll go to if we do. Anyway, police said that the firearm consists of two metal barrels attached to a wooden board more than a foot long. And why would someone go to the trouble of making their own weapon? Well, Japan's gun ownership restrictions do not allow private citizens to have handguns, and licensed hunters may own only rifles. Now, we definitely have to get into that angle of it, but Brett, like having a former world leader even successfully being assassinated is not something that happens often. It's a tragedy, I know, for a lot of people in that country and internationally. We're gonna give some of the reactions, but what do you think?
It's just shocking because gun violence in Japan is so insanely rare. Like if you watch the video that has surfaced, there's multiple videos of the actual event from different ones from like a bird's eye view, but there's another one from street level. Mm-hmm. It's a giant explosion is the sound. It's more of like a combination of a gunshot and then like the bursting of a trash bag, like a lot of air exploding at once. And no one there thinks it's gunshots because you live in a country, everyone's just kind of looking around and then they realize what happens with the second one and then he falls. But it's tough in these situations. Like Shinzo Abe, someone who has, when you look at the, I read the New York Times obituary, I'm by no means an expert on Shinzo and Abenomics, but I am, he called himself, the party is a more right, it's more nationalist. But he invested in a lot of public works, essentially, like a bunch of investment from the government in government spending, essentially, to kind of help the economy, which was not in good shape when he took over. But like, it's just one of those things where whoever is going, you can't just assassinate a politician, especially not in a country like Japan. This guy did it. He just said, "Yeah, I did it," and. And it's just the situation following it when you're learning specifics about his admission. Sure. And you don't really know exactly why he did it. You just know that he did it and then he owed up to it and then yeah. Abe's gone.
Yeah, and I get, look, I'm seeing like super chats that are coming in about things that people disagree with him on. I get that. He was just assassinated. That's what I'll say. You can't assassinate, like even if you disagree with someone, you can't assassinate. We are against political violence in every single case. We are very clear about that. It's not an opportunistic thing for us. It's unacceptable. It's very rare, obviously, especially there, as Brett was talking about. And in fact, I want to give people stats. There were 10 shootings in Japan in 2021. I would bet every dollar that I have that there have been 10 shootings in America during this episode of the Damage Report. Mm-hmm. They had 10 in a year. One person was killed, 4 people were injured. And the majority of the shootings each year are linked to Japanese organized crime. And even that means 6 or 7 I guess, even for organized crime there. That is how where it is. And we've gone over how strenuous their gun control is. People are talking about in the chat as well. You have to literally explain why it is that you want a firearm. You have to, as people are saying, describe where it is held and all of that. And as a result of that, you don't have shootings like this very often at all. Now, I have no doubt the right wing is using the fact that someone was able to effectively make an explosive device that could propel a projectile. That is a thing that you will never be able to stop people from doing. That thus, why bother? What's the point? The fact that Japan has probably, thanks to their gun control laws, saved what? Thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of their own citizens over decades will be ignored because of this tragedy. But yeah, it's devastating. Yep. We can give some comments. President Biden sent out a message saying, "I'm stunned, outraged, and deeply saddened. He was shot and killed. He was a champion of the friendship between our people. The United States stands with Japan in this moment of grief." By the way, even Donald Trump put out a statement on Truth Social about it. Was the normal deranged Trump talk, but it was positive towards Abe, and he was sad that it happened. Barack Obama tweeted, "I am shocked and saddened by the assassination of my friend and longtime partner Shinzo Abe in Japan. Former Prime Minister Abe was devoted to both the country. He served in the extraordinary alliance between the United States and Japan." And the Secretary General of the United Nations put out basically a similar comment as well. It's the sort of thing that you just do. This does not happen every year. This does not happen every 5 years. It is shocking. And whether we agree with his individual politics or his ideology overall, it's a tragedy. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.